Hello, and welcome to ArtSnacks. In this episode, we're going to create an easy Christmas card that grade school kids can make, and we're going to be using index cards, standard index cards, and we're going to be using scotch tape, and we're going to be using a marker and a pencil, paper hole punch, and colored dots, okay? So those are the things that you're going to have your kids use to make these. So let's start out like this. First thing we're going to do is take an index card. Let's just move this a little bit so we can see a little bit better. An index card. And we're going to take another index card. Okay, and we're going to put them together like this. So we'll grab a piece of tape and stick these together. You can do this in advance or have your kids do it. I'm going to go ahead and put some all the way to the corner here. And one more short piece at the top. Probably could have measured that a little bit better. Okay, now it's going to fold like this. So your card's going to be like this. There's the front. There's the inside. And the kids can do work in here and in the back. Okay, so this is your standard index card. Now we're going to draw Christmas tree. We're going to do it in three pieces. So really it's three modified triangles. So it's going to be one, two, then we'll go whoop, 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 and we'll come out of there a little bit farther down, whoop, 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 and we'll come out of there a little bit farther down, whoop, 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 whoop. Okay, so it looks like that. At the bottom, kids can come down with a little piece like this and make a kind of a thing here. And if they want to draw presents down at the bottom, they can draw presents down there. But that's what we've got so far. At the top, we're going to have a star, and we're going to use the top of the tree to help us with the bottom of the star by coming up on the 2 feet, coming out, and coming up like that. So the tree sort of helped us with the bottom of the star. And now we're going to do something really weird. We're going to cut right down the middle of this tree. We're going to cut up into this area right here. And then we're going to grab our paper hole punch. And the kids are going to get to punch six circles. Okay, they can put two on each level. One. Have them randomize that if they want to. Tell you what, I'm going to put one more over here. I put three on the bottom, so I have a total of seven little circles, okay? Now I'm going to flip that right over and tape that cut that I just made. Tape that back so it's solid again. And really we just cut so we had access with our paper hole punch. And it's okay if it's sort of, tell you what, I'm going to go over here. I guess my advice would be not to put your paper hole punch too close to that initial cut there. Now I'm going to flip it over, and the kids will take their pencils and make a mark each place where the holes go through. You can see how important it is to keep the tape away from those areas so that you can see. But this is not an exact science. Okay, so I'm going to open this up now, and everywhere where I see a mark, I'm going to put a colored dot. Okay, so I'm going to grab my dots here. And a lot of teachers, I think, might have dots in their room somewhere. So I'm going to grab a yellow dot. I'm going to randomize this a little bit. Yellow down here. Yellow up here. And red. And purple. And red. A total of seven. If you want to keep it smaller numbers so that you don't use up all your dots, as every kid's going to be using quite a few. Go back to, let's see, the purple might be best down here. Okay. Now that's done. Now when the kids flip it over, they're going to get the happy surprise of seeing the colors coming through the dots, and that's really cool. But now we're going to add a little element to that. We're going to add a little bit of color. Keeping things simple, because we don't always have a whole lot of time with our little ones, but keeping things as simple as possible, I'll get out my colors. I'm going to use green here. And the kids are going to, what they'll do is, they'll start at the bottom of these areas down here, and they'll kind of establish the bottom of each one. And if they want to kind of go dark against that, they can, against that line. Now if I take their hand this way, they can bring this up, and they're going to decrease the pressure as they come up. So it's going to look like that green is getting lighter and lighter. This is good eye-hand coordination, good practice for the kids. Motor control. So we've got some teachable things here. We could talk about how many numbers are in each section. We could talk fractions and say these are each one-third of the green part of the Christmas tree. Creative teachers out there, insert learning where appropriate. Of course, it's just fun to make a Christmas tree too. Okay, you see how those transitions sort of make the tree look a little more 3D and a little more fun. Now the kids dark down here on the bottom one more time. And lighter, lighter, lighter. I like to have the kids say that, lighter, 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 lighter. See how the little dots kind of show through and add a little shape to the tree? It's a happy accident. Now, let's add two more colors if we got them here. Let's see if we got a brown. Yeah, and a yellow. I'll add yellow for the star. Oh, I'll try that one more time. I'll add yellow for the star. Now, if they wanted to go back over their pencil lines and make those darker, they could with a pen or with a marker. Now, if the kids want to draw presents down here, they can. Now, let's do that for a bonus. On the inside, you have all these little dots. So what could those possibly be? Well, if the kids add a little square to each one of those circles, they can turn them into Christmas lights. Now, let's take a look at that. And now, they can kind of come in with two lines, and they can do some interesting things with that. Maybe come in like this. Come in, connect to this one. Connect to this one. Connect to this one, and we can have a little fun. Maybe we can do this here. Yep. How are we going to get out of here? Well, I'll introduce the concept of overlapping here. And this one goes across. Like that right there. On the inside, they can be inventive. They might say, let's say, you light up my holidays. And if you want to go back with some green on that little line that we drew there, that little electrical cord that goes to the lights, you can do that real fast. And then to make the lights light up, we can add some little light marks. We'll do that in a minute here. Do this. Through and go like this. Now let's add a few little, ooh, those are bright lights. Look how bright they are. So the hands-on learners get to draw. But you've also got some writing in there, some potential math on the front, if you want, or it can just be about the Christmas card. Okay, on the back, if you want to, let kids go back here and put in there. They could use the lines for barcode, like a Hallmark card might have, or a holiday card might have. You could have them write one more thing. They could write something that corresponds to each of these lines, so they have the same number of letters as they have lines, if you want. You could add numbers down here on the bottom. Whatever that you decide, and over here, it could have their name, and it could say, carry cards when you care enough to make it yourself with love. Okay, so there's a holiday card, and anyway, I hope you like it. See you next time.